or 6 inches or 7 inches and moved through life, suddenly we have forgotten about it. We will call names, we will fight, we will create competitions which are not having a positive orientation, we'll do backbiting. चुगली करते हैं नहीं करते बहुत मजा आता है. सो ऑल दीज थिंग्स यू नेवर वॉन्टेड समबडी टू डू टू यू. वाई हैव यू फॉरगॉटन दोज थिंग्स? सो विच एवर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन यू मे पिकअप, वेदर इट इज योर होम ऑर्गेनाइजेशन और अ सोशल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन और अ बिजनेस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, दिस कंटिन्यूज टू द बे be the basic thumb rule. Respect for every person, every human being, just like you expect to be respected. Is it asking for too much? Is it asking for too much? Who doesn't want to be respected here? Please. You don't want to be respected? So we all want to be respected, then why do we have to think twice before respecting others? This is the moot point. When you come to the classes in the morning, or when the professors meet their bosses in the morning, we say, good morning sir, madam. Now let me ask Professor Satish a small question. Sir, you have some conduct rules for yourself, for the faculty members also, service conduct rules. Does it contain a condition that when you meet your boss in the morning, you have to say good morning? Professor Satish says that there is no conduct rule which requires him to say good morning to his boss when he meets him in the morning. I am sure there is no conduct rules for the students here to stand up when the teacher comes in or to say good morning when they meet. And if you don't do that, nobody can do any harm to you because it is not in the rule book. If somebody tries to do something, the rule book will not support him. That doesn't mean that from tomorrow you stop doing that. But still we do that. Why? We do that because certain values have been inculcated in us. Certain social norms have evolved over a period of time. And we have accepted those things because social living requires certain amount of discipline and decorum. Now who amongst us wants to be absolutely free? Anybody who doesn't want to be free? Everybody wants to be free? Everybody wants to be free? If you are free, then what will you do? If I am free, I'll go and slap somebody. I'm free. I can do whatever I want. I can call names. I'll dress as I dress in my bedroom and then come to the office. I'm free. So freedom has a connotation. Freedom means different things in different situations and circumstances. So long you are in your room, you are alone, you can do whatever you want, whichever way you want, you are independent, free. But There is another man who is in the next room. He is absolutely independent and free, living his own way. But the moment two persons come in contact with each other, certain amount of freedom gets curtailed. If I come to meet Professor Mathur, he will expect me that I should be at least decently dressed. I should be speaking decently. Similarly, I would also be expecting that. So what is happening? My freedom is getting constrained. There are limits being imposed on my freedom as an individual if I am coming into a social interaction mode. And that is the beauty of social living. Okay? Therefore, to use freedom, there is nothing called absolute freedom. Freedom has a cost, freedom has constraints, and it imposes certain restraint. We have our values which evolve it. Now somebody should ask me, why are you talking about all this? We have listened to all this all the time from our childhood. I'm talking to you on these things because a business organization is nothing but a magnified room, magnified a magnification of the smallest entity of social organization, that is a family. What all happens in a family happens exactly the same way in the business organization. So the rules that apply within the family get magnified and enlarged depending upon the needs of the organization. And it also takes care of those things which are rules or regulations or development or ethos of different regions from where people come to build that organization, because they come with their own cultural elements. But at the root of all organizational working is that we need to have respect for people, seniors, juniors, workers, supervisors, wherever, whoever, whenever. Now the point comes that when we go to an organization as a management trainee, we have supervisors who are 20 years older than us. And they feel that we have come and we are going to sit on their heads. And the importance which they had because of their experience is not of any value to the management. This is not a correct picturization. Therefore, whenever we move into an organization, a business organization, or any organization where we are going to work as managers, we have to be consciously reminded of this fact that we as youngsters, I was also a youngster like you when I started my career with Steel Authority about 33 years back, and faced the same problems which are being faced by my boys and girls today. So when we go in, we should think that he is not an outsider and I have not suddenly landed from the moon. I, as a management trainee, have imbibed learnings based on whatever curriculum we have gone through, the latest and most sophisticated knowledge that we are having. Now, this knowledge needs to be blended with the experience of the people who have been there. And there has to be a learning cycle between both these two groups, where the youngsters share knowledge from the current learnings, and the elders, they transmit their knowledge of the systems in which they have operated. This sort of mechanism is now being referred to as knowledge management. All organizations try to document these learnings for posterity to be used subsequently. So you have the knowledge, they have the skills, and we need to blend it. Number one, we have to have the attitude to take everybody together. Everybody. It is often said, Hindi mein ek muhavra hai ki akela chana bhaar nahi padta. But वो अकेला चना ही हो, अकेले ही रहेगा तभी वो इनोवेट कर पाएगा, लीड कर पाएगा. लेकिन उस लीड करने के लिए, उसकी लीडरशिप को एक्सेप्ट करने के लिए, जब तक लोग नहीं है जो उसको एक्सेप्ट करके मानते हो, तो वो किनारे बैठ के गाता रहेगा, चल अकेला चल अकेला चल अकेला, नहीं होगा. तो इसलिए सबको साथ लेके चलना जरूरी है. जिस माहौल में हम लोग काम करें वहां का भाषा ज्ञान बहुत अच्छा होता है, क्योंकि आज भी हम लोग अंग्रेजी में बात करते हैं, लेकिन अधिकतर समय जब ऑफिशियल काम कर रहे होते हैं तभी अंग्रेजी में बात करते हैं. दफ्तर पहुंचने के पहले तक घर में सब काम अपनी मातृभाषा में करते हैं, हिंदी, तमिल, मराठी, गुजराती, जो भी है. सोचने का क्रम भी अपनी मातृभाषा में ही चलता है. लेकिन पता नहीं इन सीढ़ियों में क्या तकलीफ हो जाती है, इन सीढ़ियों तक पहुंचते हुए, दफ्तर की जो सीढ़ियां आती हैं, जिन सीढ़ियों से चढ़ के हम अपने दफ्तर में या इंस्टीट्यूट में पहुंचते हैं, कि उनसे चढ़ के अंदर आते आते क्लासरूम में बैठते बैठते हम लोग इंग्लिश मय हो जाते हैं, फिर इंग्लिश मय हो जाते हैं. तो मैं एक कार्यक्रम में था, वहां एक कवि महोदय थे, राजभाषा का कार्यक्रम चल रहा था. तो जब यह बात मैंने वहां रखी तो उन्होंने कहा कि अनुपम जी, दोष उन सीढ़ियों का ही है, व्यक्तियों का नहीं है. तो मैं कहना ये चाह रहा था कि अगर आप हिंदी भाषी हैं और किसी अहिंदी भाषी क्षेत्र में आपसे कोई हिंदी भाषी मिल जाता है, या आप बंगला भाषी हैं, किसी अबंगला भाषी क्षेत्र में आपसे कोई बंगला भाषी मिल जाता है, तो आपको कैसा लगता है? लगता है ना कि हमारे ये तरफ का है, उससे घनिष्ठता थोड़ी पहले होगी. कोई फ्रांस से इंडिया आता है, उसको आप एयरपोर्ट पे अगर फ्रेंच भाषा में बोल करके वेलकम करते हैं तो कितना एट होम फील करता है तुरंत. तो रैपो बिल्डिंग इज अनदर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एक्टिविटी ऑफ अ मैनेजर. हाउ यू डू इट, देयर इज नो थंब रूल. और बुनियादी बात यह है मित्रों कि जिस क्षेत्र में भी आप काम करें, चाहे मटेरियल्स मैनेजमेंट में हो, फाइनेंस में हो, ऑपरेशंस में हो, ऑल रिजल्ट्स विल कम ओनली थ्रू पीपल. यू विल बी गिविंग रिजल्ट्स ओनली थ्रू पीपल. सो वेदर यू आर अ मटेरियल्स मैनेजर और अ फाइनेंस मैनेजर और वॉट एवर मैनेजर, यू आर प्राइमरली अ एचआर मैनेजर, बिलीव इट और नॉट सर. यू हैव टू हैव द एचआर स्किल्स whether or not you are primarily concerned with HR function. This is a bunyadi part. Okay. Lot of discussions are taking place these days about innovation. In fact, it has become quite fashionable and stylish to talk about innovation. I know innovation management, and so on and so forth. All organizations are talking about it. Because we basically read management or practice management what has been taught by the Firangi management teachers. How much it is relevant to us, how much it has been modulated to meet our requirements, and the practicability of those regulations. There are lots of question marks on this. And a lot of management gurus in India also have spoken and written about these things. If you want to transplant a mechanism from Japan into India, it has to be properly linked with the basic infrastructure and the social parameters and performance indicators and required elements for it to be accepted, and then and only then it will flourish. Otherwise, if it is not nourished, it would lead to incidences like what? Anybody? Somebody heard about what happened in Maruti sometime back? Mane sir? Something which happened in Chennai? So, you cannot totally transplant something from one environment to another. It has to be aligned to the structures prevailing in the society in that particular region. Those of you who are planning to move into the field of human resources management per se, please note that there is no shortcut to labor laws. Like it or not, you have to have them here. When I say you have to have it here, it doesn't mean that you should memorize the whole Bear Act and things like that. But at least you should be aware about the basic tenets, the provisions, and you should also know, if required, where to refer to in times of need. Nobody expects you to memorize all those 101 labor laws. I hope your management course has some elements on labor laws also. I would request you to kindly increase the number of papers, because labor laws, collective bargaining, all these things need to be re-emphasized in view of what changes have taken place in the society in the couple of past years. And more industrial visits would also help. I would also request, if it is possible,